Hello friends, in this video we are going to see about error control mechanisms used in sliding window flow control methods. At the end of this course, we are going to understand the working mechanisms of various error control methods and we are going to compare the performance of these methods. The goals: we are trying to find the effect of errors and how to control these errors in sliding window flow control mechanism, and there are two methods are defined. The first is go back n ARQ, it is standing for automatic repeat request, and second is select to reject automatic repeat request. At the end we are going to compare the performance of these two methods. Before we start the actual mechanism, let us try to understand some important terms used in sliding window flow control method. In this mechanism, we use the frame based communication. Each frame is given with the sequence number. Then at the sender side we manage one window. Also we manage one window at receiver side. Before they start communication, we define the window size, and finally during communication they use a feedback signal. It is named as receiver ready for nth sequence number. Let us try to understand the basic working mechanism of sliding window flow control. There are two sides are shown in the figure. One is transmitter, other is a receiver. At the transmitter side we manage one window, it is called sender's window, and also we manage one window at receiver, it is called receiver's window. The size of windows are very much same. At the sender side, the sender stores all the frames which he want to transmit on the channel. The sender sends some frames on the channel. In the figure, it is shown that it is sending frame F1, F2, F3 and F4. And after some time, the frames are coming at receiver side. The receiver is applying some check against error and he is going to plan the feedback. Now in the figure, it is shown that the receiver is applying check on frame F1, F2, F3 and he is planning for giving the feedback here. So he gives the feedback as RR4. It means that he acknowledges all the three frames, that is F1, F2, F3, and he is waiting for the fourth frame onwards here. Now in this method, in this case, even the frame number 4 is received correctly, and suppose the feedback is coming as RR4, the sender has to start its next phase of transmission from the frame number 4. That is, frame number 4 is discarded by the receiver. This is the policy we use in the sliding window flow control mechanism. Now we will consider errors on the channel during communication. Now in the practical channels, we normally are finding some errors on the channel. Now these errors are because of noises and various parameters occurring on the channels. Now because of these errors, the data inside the data frame is get changed here. That is, the 0 may change to 1 or 1 may change to 0 here. And this single bit error is going to garble entire frame, because a single bit error is going to mismatch the checksum that we insert in the frame, and the receiver side is going to give the feedback as the negative acknowledgement. Now there are two types of error control methods we define. The first is called go back n ARQ, and second is select to reject ARQ. Let us try to understand the working mechanism of go back n. Now in this diagram, again the sender is going to plan to send the frame F1, F2, F3, F4. And after some time these frames are coming at receiver side. And again receiver is going to apply the check against error. And first he is going to keep all the received frames in the window, that is F1, F2, F3 and F4. And when he checks the frame F2 against error, he is finding some error here. and so that he is going to plan the feedback as RR2. The number 2 is going to acknowledge the frame F1, and he also denotes that the receiver is going to expect the frames 2 onwards here. Now getting this feedback on sender side, the sender again plan for the next phase of communication by realigning its window. That is, he will start its next phase of communication from F2 and onwards here. That is F2, F3, F4 and onwards here. Now in this case, even this frame F3 and F4 are received by receiver successfully, the sender is going to start its communication from frame number 2 onwards here. That is, frame number 3 and frame number 4 are discarded by the receiver. This kind of mechanism is called as the go back in ARQ method. Let us try to understand one more method here. It is called selective reject ARQ mechanism. Now again in this diagram, the sender is planning to send the frame F1, F2, F3 and F4. Again the same thing is happening here. The F2 is having error inside the frame. So the receiver is going to give the feedback as the feedback signal. Now like in this case, the feedback signal is taken as REJ. And after that we are going to write the frame number in which we are finding the error. In this case, we are having error inside the frame number 2. Now when this feedback comes back to the sender side, the sender only repeats the frame F2 and he will continue to send the previous frames onwards here. That is, he will plan to send the frame F5, F6 and onwards here. That is, in this mechanism, we only repeat that frame which is under error. And this kind of method is called as selective repeat, or also it can be called as selective reject method. Now how to compare the performance of these two different methods here? Now to understand the effect of its performance, we take two things into account. The first is total delay of transmission, and second is the bandwidth required for entire file transmission. Now just try to put a question here. Out of these two methods, which is the best method? And when to use which method during communication? Now, in the go back end method, the transmitter is going to repeat some of the frames he already sent on the channel. Hence, in this method, we require more frames to transmit to send this entire file. And because we are sending more frames in this method, we also require more bandwidth on the network. Now, whereas in the selective reject ARQ, in this method, the transmitter only transmits those frames which are under error. And he is not repeating any additional frame except the error frame on the channel. Hence, we require less time period to transmit the entire file on the channel. And also, we require less bandwidth because we are having less frames to transmit. Now, going beyond, now when to use which method? Now actually go back end method is recommended for those networks in which errors are occurring frequently on networks. Because the error pattern normally we encounter, it is seen that when error is coming in a single frame, it remains for number of frames on the given channel. It is normally happening with the networks having low performance issues there. So go back end methods is recommended for those networks which are having some lower performances during communication. Whereas the selective reject ARQ method is recommended for those networks which are very good and they are having very less errors during communication. That is, there are networks which are having better performance during communication. So it is found that in these networks, errors are coming quite rarely, and even these errors are coming on network, they don't remain more than one frame here. So in this case, we are recommending a method which is called the selective reject ARQ. So as I underline, we can say go back end method is recommended for those networks which are having poor performances or errors are coming quite frequently. And the select to reject method is used in that network in which the error is coming quite rarely. Now these are my references. I use two books here. One is Forosen, other is William Stallings.